powering forward on his own, looking for some support, but it looks like the Stars may have this one cleared up, and they do. Well, Dryden Dow makes a pass to Kelso, who just struggled to get a
nice movement there from
the Stars. Very good movement indeed. They find a teammate and he can't. And Dunbar clears that one up very well there, getting the puck to Linden. And Dunbar's back in again. And well, they are, would you know it?
Waters.
Yeah. A good bit of play there from.
Yeah, Waters is right in front of goal. Backhand in.
Yeah, we'll see it back here. The persistence of Dunbar manages to get that pass into Waters, who's waiting and looking to put it in the back of the net. We can see it here. Dunbar knows exactly where he's going to be, and into the back of the net that goes. And the Guildford Flames take a 1-0 lead away from home with 13:12 left of the first period.
Waters allowed to ghost in there, unmarked. Nice play here.
Yeah, Joshua Waller. Well, that play is broke up by the Stars, and Lucas Lindvall looking to try and get that puck from Corbin Baldwin. And well, Stars fans not happy with Eric Lindhagen there, but the Stars still got it in the danger area. And well, Waller stops Lucas Lindvall from.
Flames doing a great job of shutting the men down.
Yeah.
Trying to decrease.
Well, there's a glove and a stick stuck in between the boards. I've never seen that before. You ever witnessed that before, Barry Graham?
Never seen that one before. Wee job for Bob the Builder here, I think.
Yeah, looks like it's going to be. Flames look to press forward here. Evan Ritt. And well, that play is broken up. Oh. And well, here you go.
No, that looked pretty serious.
That certainly
behind.
Did. We'll get a replay of that, hopefully.
No hesitation.
Blue shard there.
Looks like Evan Ritt was it.
Also, apparently, unbiased for away fans. Well, you didn't hear Old Dog on Wednesday night, Jules, against the Cardiff Devils. Only kidding. he was. We try our best to do that here.
Well, that's Bouchard taking a stick in the face there. The referee in a good position to spot that one. And all of a sudden, it's got quite feisty in here. And he's needing some attention in there behind the goal. Forward goes Lindhagen, Dunbar on the line, sends it into the centre. Big shot comes in, it's over the top, rebound pops off the plexi as well. It's collected by the Flames and send it round. Oh, awkward bounce off the boards. Out in front, good chance here. Shot comes in, dings the post on its way past. Well, tying up in the corner here. Pass out in front, oh, it's just not connected. And a chance here for the Stars on the breakaway. Very quickly up the right-hand side goes hard. Lays this one off for Lindvall. Lindvall gets himself around, plays it back through. It's defend. Shock for Hart. Just can't get it through the traffic, loose in front, and it's down on that one, Carozzi, and some handbags as well. Some desperate defending there in front of the goalie, and it's paid off. Lindhagen takes a sore one in the process. As Dow wins it back in the neutral zone, needs to wait on his teammates coming back out, and back in, and a scrap, I think, off the play, perhaps. Dow. And it's not going anywhere, I don't think. But Dow and Dunbar having some words. And I think they will sit. Or at least one of them. Yes, both of them.
Yeah,
thought as much. Naughty boys, sit down in the corner and think about what you've done. having to be chin work. And a good movement here from Guildford, pulling the stars all around. No way through at the moment though. And that's Lundvald has drawn a penalty there. Waters into the boards. So Lundvald's going to sit here. Not sure about that one, but hey ho. So at the end of this period, we'll have the thoughts of Omar Pasha, the Stars head coach and general manager. Steve's gone rickside to chat to him. Shave right on the death of the period there as well. I think it's got to be covered. No one can see the puck there. So I've got to blow a whistle. Absolute pile on in the crease as well.
Well, coach, how would you sum up those first two periods for the Stars?
I mean, on both sides, there's a lack of energy. I thought we had a bit more energy in the second. We were skating a bit harder. We're getting more involved, and we're getting chances. So hopefully, it goes in the third.
Yeah, as you say, just one chance, that's all it takes, and it would give your guys a boost of energy, you think?
Yeah, I mean, you can tell we're a bit tired from, you know, the last few weeks, but listen, there's 20 minutes now, the guys just have to leave everything on the ice.
Best of luck, Omar, thanks.
All right, thank you.
Down to Hart in the corner. Hart goes down under the challenge. And the Flames will send it around the boards, but in goes Boutin again. Kept in just in the nick of time. Bouchard runs out of space. Forward goes Acker. Now Reddick. Big shot, big save. Well, quick break there from the Flames with Acker and Reddick. Combining well, the shot on target, and it's into the glove for Brogan. King will send that in. Lundvald runs into trouble. We'll try again. On the left-hand side, still going as well. Chance here for Lundvald. Can't get it through traffic. Oh, good save, Carozzi. He recovered extremely well there. Lundvald injecting some energy into this game. And Carozzi has earned his wages right there.
Yeah, an incredible bit of work for him.
Boutin on the line. Fires that one in. It's hitting someone in the back of the head there, I think. Oh, and that's a boarding call all day long right there. He did put the brakes on at the last moment. But Janssen is going to sit for that. So out to the line for Boutin. And again, the forecheck here from the Flames is troublesome. Waters giving the Stars no time on the puck there at all. Close them down very quickly.
Well, good opportunity here for the Stars to grab that goal they're needing. And
yeah, sure is. Chance here. Oh, that's Jordan Cowney, and Waters is going to get himself in a bad ball there as well. And amongst all that, he took Cowney out in the middle of his celebration, and it's all going to kick off here. But you know what, after all is said and done, it's one each with 10:27 remaining. Jordan Cowney, man on the score sheet for the Stars.
Yeah, and a regular occurrence for Jordan Cowney this season, being on the score sheet. Very, very impressive start to the season he's had. Well, here you go, Dave.
Yeah, he's going to go.
Yep.
Rapturous applause for him heading back to the bench. some discussions in the ref crease as well. Yeah, look at that, that's a team spirit right there. All five Stars players getting stuck right in there.
Right in, yeah.
So the call against Jansen has actually given us check from behind as well, not a boarding call. That's my mistake, of course. Not the first and it won't be the last.
We make mistakes on a
minute by minute basis.
I was going to say, second by second basis, but yeah, I think.
Not that bad.
I think, yeah. Well, Johan Andersson, Dundee Stars captain, having good words with the officials, and the same at the other end with Omar Pasha and Paul Dixon.
Yeah, so basically, Ian Waters is now going to head to the penalty box after his shenanigans. A wry smile from him as well. He knows what he got.
Yeah. Well, we're entertained in a way, as everybody watching this is now. One apiece. Coming up for 10 minutes left, and well. Yeah, well, there was...
The referees have missed a high stick into the face of Bush up there.
A major miss there.
The crowd go mental. And that's a collision there, and there's no call on that one either. A hint of kneeing, perhaps. So, yeah, it's got all exciting and a bit feisty all of a sudden. Twists and turns, gets the pass away as well. 8.5 minutes on the clock then. Oh, giveaway in the zone here. This could be dangerous. Flames with a shot in as well, deflection. Covered well. Ackard didn't quite get a hold of that the first time. He still got it the second time though. Stars done a good job of keeping to the outside. It's a hand in the air, delayed penalty call. And Carozzi makes his way to the bench, and just as he gets there, the whistle goes. And there's a hint of this getting out of control a little bit.
Yeah, there certainly is. Certainly getting fiery now.
Nice move here. Reddick offloads this one for Ackard. Reddick again on the boards, back out to the point for Ackard again, and Reddick moves back inside for this one. Shot comes in, scores! He's gone over the shoulder. Cruz Reddick puts the Guildford Flames back into the lead on the power play with 7.5 minutes to go in this game. It's Dundee 1, Guildford 2.
Yeah, well, a good goal to take the lead on the power play, and you see it back here. And a nice shot into the net. And well, they go for Flames 2-1 ahead with 7:30 left. Well, Mike M had sent in a picture who's going to score the next winning goal. game-winning goal, and well, Lewis thought it was Waters, but he's in the box. He was right in terms of the next goal being scored by a Guildford Flames, though. So well done to you, Lewis, and Stars got some work to do here.
Oh, it's another one! Well, it's a disastrous minute or so for the Stars.
Yeah.
And a mistake in the zone there. Jamie Crooks takes full advantage. 7:14 to go, it's Dundee 1, Guildford 3. And it's all gone a bit wrong.
It certainly has. 2-goal lead to the Flames take now. Well, the Stars have got a lot of work to do in 7 minutes and 14 seconds. You can see it's all gone a little bit wrong indeed. And well, the score is 3-1 Guildford with 7:14 left.
Take this puck out in the corner then, it's Davies in behind. And the Stars need to shut up shop here fairly sharpish. Another one, you've got to think that would be absolutely game over. As it is though, you never know.
Yeah, only takes a goal back from the Stars, and they certainly had the comeback goals last night very late on in the game.
Here goes Brian Hart as well. Hart pushing this one off. Shot comes in, scores, and it's marked. Mark Hart takes the pass from Brian Hart and rattles the back of the net with that one, and they pull it a goal back straight away. Dundee 2, Guildford 3. That's three goals in about a minute and a half, I think. Unbelievable.
Yeah, well, Matt Marquardt in the penalty box for the Guildford Flames' second goal of the evening. And then you can see here he's made amends with that one. Put the Stars back in this. 3-2 with 6:32 left. Tell you, if you're looking for entertainment tonight, this is the place to be.
Aye. Third period. It's all happening. Loses an out. Dow gets a stick in. Shot comes in there. Deflection takes that one high. Bounces down in front. Chance almost for Dryden Dow. Lundvald. Shot comes in. Not through traffic. And a quick pass up the centre. This is a great move here for the Flames. Chance in. Oh, Hogan makes a great save from John Dunbar. That could have been extremely dangerous and bad news for the Stars. Something though. To Dow. 3 minutes left. Chipped over, clubbed nicely down by Lundvald. Across the line he goes, sends it through, it's gone right into Craig's face, loose in front. Oh, Karachi holds on. Well, it was awkwardly bouncing around there. Lundvald will keep that in the corner as well, actually. Back one hard in there, and that's up into the nets and over the plexi. 2:12 on the clock. Everyone wearing blue and red, shouting for delay again there. Well, the final chess pieces are on the board. The Stars running out of time here to get a point at least in this game. They dump this in the corner. Hart will give chase. Tie up on the boards. Everyone battling hard at this one in the corner. Who's got the puck? Oh, it's off, it's ripped off, in on the open goal, and he scores. Well, the Stars could not hold on to that in the offensive zone. With 16.2 seconds remaining, Evan Ritz gets up, scores the ENG. It's Dundee 2, Guildford 4. It's been a good weekend for them. Yeah, that is going to be us on Dundee Stars Live this evening. Final buzzer sounds. And the final score is Dundee Stars 2, Guildford Flames 4. An empty net goal just at the end of the game there from Evan Ritt, putting the icing on the cake for the visitors, and they will take the 2 points this evening despite the Stars' best efforts, particularly in that third and final period. And it is Karotze who picks up man of the match. Can't argue with that either, I guess. Look at this. I mean, these are minors presenting beer to the man of the match. What's going on there? Somebody needs to ID that guy. So the Guildford Flames fans who have made the trip up to Dundee on a Sunday night, making plenty of noise in support of their team. And they'll be happy. We'll leave Dundee with 2 points in the bag. And it's Connor Cox who picks up the man of the match for the Stars this evening. and some photographs as well. So there we go,